Good morning, students, and welcome to another online biology classroom of St. Michael's Academy. Hope all of you are well and your exam, you have given already exam, so hope so, it is good. So now, today we are going to start photosynthesis from plant physiology. In my slide, I have followed the reduced syllabus. The instruction of reduced syllabus as given by the board. Photosynthesis is a very easy topic. Already you have read it. So let's start today's class. So first, we are starting with the definition. Photosynthesis is the process by which green plants and some other organisms use sunlight to synthesize nutrients from carbon dioxide and water. Photosynthesis in plants generally involves the green pigment chlorophyll and generates oxygen as a byproduct. You can see three diagrams has been given. In first one, the process of photosynthesis has been shown, where in presence of sunlight, photosynthesis procedure is going on. In the second one, how chloroplast involves in photosynthesis, how glucose is forming, that has been shown. So glucose synthesizers of the cell is chloroplast. And in the third one, the total process in a gist form has been shown. Now that you have to remember that organ of photosynthesis, green leaves or green parts of plants. Second one, photosynthetic tissue, mesophyll tissue of leaves. Third one, organelle of photosynthesis, that is chloroplast. This is very important, that's why separately I have given one diagram for it. Number four, unit of harvesting light energy, that is antenna complex. Number five, plants which carried out maximum photosynthesis, about 90% of the total photosynthesis in the world is carried out by algae growing in sea. And number six, photosynthetic bacteria, chlorobium, and others bacteria, that is like you can say Heliobacterium, etc. Now, what is the site of photosynthesis? In plants, photosynthesis takes place in chloroplast, which contain the chlorophyll. Chloroplast is surrounded by a double membrane and contain a third inner membrane called the thylakoid membrane that forms long folds within the organelle. Now one question, why photosynthesis is called an anabolic process? Because the metabolic process by means of which increase in dry weight of the body of the living organism occurs is called anabolic process. In the process of photosynthesis, the complex substance glucose, you know about glucose, formula is C6H12O6. So the complex substance glucose here is produced in the chloroplast due to the utilization of simpler substances like soil, water, atmospheric carbon dioxide, energy from the sun, whereby increase in dry weight of the plant body takes place and also energy is stored. Hence, photosynthesis is regarded as an anabolic process. Now the second question, why is photosynthesis called carbon assimilation? During the dark phase of photosynthesis, the carbon of carbon dioxide of the atmosphere is utilized in the preparation of glucose. As if I say C6H12O6, the inclusion of carbon from the atmospheric carbon dioxide in the cell component is called carbon assimilation. As the carbon assimilation process occurs during photosynthesis in presence of light, hence photosynthesis is also called carbon assimilation. Now we are talking about photosynthetic pigment. A photosynthetic pigment, that is accessory pigment, chloroplast pigment, antenna pigment, is a pigment that is present in chloroplast or photosynthetic bacteria and captures the light energy necessary for photosynthesis. So there are the names of photosynthetic pigment. One is carotene. This is an orange pigment. Second one is xanthophyll, a yellow pigment. Pheophytin A, a gray-brown pigment. Pheophytin B, a yellow-brown pigment. And the most important two, chlorophyll A, a blue-green pigment, and chlorophyll B, a yellow-green pigment. Now you can see the diagram. Here the wavelength of lights has been taken by x-axis, that is in nanometer, and through y-axis, relative absorption, that is percentage of this pigment, has been taken. So if we draw a graph, you can see the graph, chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, carotenoids, phycoerythrin, phycocyanin. So everything has been shown over here. I have not given you structure of these pigments because this is not in your syllabus. I have checked. So this much only, if you will read, from this only you will get common question in your board. So here is the equation or reaction of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is usually represented by the equation 6CO2 plus 12H2O, which forms C6H12O6, that is glucose, plus 6O2 plus 6H2O in presence of light, that means sunlight, and chlorophyll. During this process, organisms such as plants go through the light dependent and light independent reactions to convert carbon dioxide and water into sugars and oxygen. The equation shows that the main components of this process are carbon dioxide, water, sunlight, and chlorophyll. In the above reaction, 6 molecules of carbon dioxide combine with 12 molecules of water in presence of sunlight with the help of chlorophyll. In this reaction, 1 molecule of glucose, 6 molecules of oxygen, and 6 molecules of water are formed. The oxygen evolved during photosynthesis comes from water. Oxygen of glucose is coming from CO2. Reactions of photosynthesis take place in the photochloroplast. The amount of CO2 taken in is equal to the amount of oxygen liberated. Light energy and chlorophyll take active role in photosynthesis. Now, the principal components of photosynthesis. During the process of photosynthesis, cells use carbon dioxide and energy from the sun to make sugar molecules and oxygen. These sugar molecules are the basis for more complex molecules made by the photosynthetic cell, such as glucose. Leaves are the main photosynthetic organs in plants, and thus they are eminently important for growth and biomass accumulation. So you can say in the process of photosynthesis, the essential major components are light, water, carbon dioxide, photosynthetic pigments, and other accessory ingredients. Among these components, water and carbon dioxide are regarded as raw materials required in this process. What are the stages of photosynthesis in order? It is convenient to divide the photosynthetic process in plants into four stages, each occurring in a defined area of the chloroplast. Number 1, absorption of light. Number 2, electron transport leading to the reduction of NADP plus to NADPH. Number 3, generation of ATP. And number 4, conversion of CO2 into carbohydrates, that is carbon fixation. You can see in the diagram thylakoid, stroma, and chloroplast area, it has been shown which phases occurs where. Now, the light reactions of photosynthesis involve light-driven electron and proton transfers, which occur in the thylakoid membrane, whereas the dark reactions involve the fixation of CO2 into carbohydrate via the Kelvin-Benson cycle, which occurs in the stroma. Now you see the second diagram, how the light reaction and dark reaction occurs. It has been clearly shown over there. Now cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. As the name suggests, in cyclic photophosphorylation, the electrons move in a circular pattern. Electron movement is non-cyclic in non-cyclic photophosphorylation. Now, what is photophosphorylation? The addition of phosphate group in the presence of light during the light reaction of photosynthesis is called photophosphorylation. Now, here light reaction and dark reaction. Pictures are here. You can see, you will understand. Just remember, cyclic photophosphorylation occurs in the cyclic electron transport system, and non-cyclic photophosphorylation occurs in the non-cyclic electron transport system. The first one is single stage process involving only the photosystem 1, and the second one is two stage process involving both photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. The proton pump is cytochrome complex which stays in between ferredoxin and plastocyamine in case of cyclic photophosphorylation. The proton pump is cytochrome complex that stays in between plastoquinone and plastocyanin in case of non-cyclic photophosphorylation. Water is not utilized in cyclic photophosphorylation, so proton is produced by cytochrome B6 complex only. But in other process, proton is produced from splitting of water as well as by the cytochrome B6 complex. Cyclic one produces neither oxygen nor NADPH, but non-cyclic one produces both oxygen and NADPH. What is electron transport chain or ETC in photosynthesis? Chlorophyll, which is present in photosystems, soaks up light energy. The energized electrons are then used to make NADPH. The electron transport chain is a series of molecules that accept or donate electrons easily. When hydrogen ions move through the protein and down the electron transport chain, ATP is created. Now see the diagram, you can understand how the process of ETC is going on. For any doubts or queries, please email me at sudeshna1.sma@outlook.com. We also welcome your responses by way of your views and feedback on the PPTs or videos at feedback.stmichaelsacademy@gmail.com. Thank you, students. Hope you have understood well and have a nice day.